New at 6, a new look for the CHP. This is a mock-up of the Highway Patrol's new fleet of SUVs you may one day see in your rearview mirror. But with California facing another budget deficit, why is the state spending millions on new cars?
KCRI3's David Bienick is live in Sacramento with the recently approved cruiser contract. David?
Kelly, Edie, good evening. Yes, the state says it'll be several more months before we start to see these cars on the road, including I-5 behind me. Several more months at least. No money has actually been approved yet for these car purchases, but the bidding process is now over and a winner has been declared.
Ever since Ford announced last year that it would no longer be making Crown Victorias, CHP and other police agencies have been trying to figure out what to buy next. Recently, the CHP decided its next generation of cruisers would be this, a hefty version of a Ford Explorer SUV made specifically for law enforcement and known as the Interceptor. This altered photograph shows what an Interceptor will look like with CHP markings.
We're giving officers more space, more cargo capacity, all-wheel drive for all sorts of terrains.
The state has signed a contract to pay $26,578 for each new Interceptor. And one local dealer says that's more than $1,000 too much. Bill Kemmery with Elk Grove Auto Group says he offered to sell the state a fleet of Dodge Chargers for about $1,700 less.
Well, I expected them to buy, using taxpayer money, the least expensive product out there, and they've chosen not to do that.
The state admits the Charger and other sedans are cheaper, but say they could not meet the CHP's requirement to be able to carry safely 1,500 pounds of people and equipment.
We need to ensure that we're not exceeding the payload capacity on any of our vehicles. It at the end of the day, is a safety issue for our state employees.
Now, the state says the Charger's weight capacity came up about 39 pounds too short, 39 pounds. But the Dodge dealer says that's not true. He says that the Charger actually exceeds the state's and the CHP's weight requirement by about 15 pounds, and he wants the state to reconsider his bid. Live in Sacramento, David Bean, KCRA3 reports.
So, David, how are local police and sheriff's departments dealing with the issue, and how do they really decide which cars to buy?
Yeah, local police departments are faced with this same issue. Many of them had Crown Victorias before, and many of them take their cue from the state and simply buy what the CHP plans to buy. The Dodge dealer says when you take into account all those local departments, the Interceptor's extra cost adds up to $80 million total for California taxpayers.
All right, David Bienick live for us in Sacramento. David, thanks.